In early 1986, I started to see these little pink rubber figures in the toy aisles of Kmart in packs of four for a dollar, and I wanted to collect every one I could find. By the summer, I had about 90 of them, including some bootleg versions that I got out of the gumball machines at the front of the store. I kept them all in a giant Ziploc bag, and they were the only toys I brought with me on my trip to Buffalo, New York that summer before 8th grade. They were called Muscle. Millions of unusual small creatures lurking everywhere. And they were one of the top 10 selling toys that year. It looked like there was millions of different figures to collect, with only two of them having names. Good guy Muscle Man and bad guy Terry Bull. When I saw the commercial for them, I noticed one of the figures was a giant hand, and I became obsessed with tracking this figure down.
Invasion of the Muscle Things. They've come to drive America nuts. They're ugly, they're weird, they're tiny, they're terrible.
And they're pink!
There are hundreds of them. It's an epidemic.
I'm going crazy!
Dad, catch them!
Muscle Things. Hundreds of different I don't know whats. They run in packs of 4, 10, or 28, sold separately from Mattel. How many can you capture?
Hey, do you want to see the Italian version of that commercial?
Migliaia, migliaia, milioni!
Exogini, i misteriosi alieni.
Arrivano dappertutto!
Exogini!
Sono incredibilmente invincibili! Non c'è luogo sulla Terra dove non si possano trovare!
Exogini, i misteriosi alieni!
Perché sono venuti sul nostro pianeta? Chi sono? Da dove vengono?
Exogini!
La più grande collezione extraterrestre! Exogini, i misteriosi alieni sono solo...
I found out my friend Chris Wesner had that claw figure, but no amount of my allowance would convince him to sell it to me. Not even $4. Muscle also came in packs of 10, crammed inside these little plastic garbage cans just clear enough to see the silhouette of the figures pressed up against the insides. And it was in the bottom of one of these cans in a Kmart in New York that summer that I saw the shape of that hand figure and convinced my aunt to buy it for me. There were also four different 28 packs of figures, a wrestling ring with some figures, wrestling belts, a board game, and more, but these were all out of my price range.
Muscle invasion update. Scientists discover Muscle Things have come to wrestle. America's only hope, the battling belt and the wrestling ring.
He moves left. He's hooked one. Into the battling belt it goes. He's got another. Folks, this wrestling ring may save the world. One more to go. He's got him. His battling belt is full. Hard knocking, rocking ring, battling belt, muscle figure packs each sold separately. New from Mattel. Can you save the world?
The following year, I was at my friend Mike's house, and he showed me his collection of Muscle figures. They were the new ones that had just come out, but they were exactly like mine, only now they were being made in multiple new colors. There was red figures and blue figures, green, purple. There was 10 colors in all now, and I didn't like them. I liked the uniformity of the original flesh-colored figures, and just trying to collect each different character that I didn't yet own.
The people versus Muscle. Millions are being captured. America is safe.
Muscle Things, what could be worse?
Muscle, part two. They're orange, they're green, they're purple.
And worse.
Muscle Things in disguise. They're hiding everywhere.
I can't stand them!
I can't stop them!
Muscle Part 2. Hundreds hide in packs, separately sold. Muscle 2, people nothing.
What I did like, though, is how he was grouping them into special teams, and he would give them names. Like he would take all the figures that had parts of tools on them, like drill bits and pliers, and he put them into a group called the Wrecking Crew. That was pretty cool. But Muscle Toys disappeared from stores by the end of that year as the market fell out of the entire industry with the advent of the Nintendo Entertainment System completely taking over. In fact, I think everyone I knew got a Nintendo that Christmas, including me. The following year, in 1988, I would sell all of my toys. keeping only my Nintendo and forgetting all about these muscle figures. 9 years later, in 1997, I was surfing the internet with my web TV, which was a cheap alternative to getting online without having to buy a computer. And I came across a website called the MPS, the Muscle Preservation Society. Founded the year before, Darren Vindwala had created the world's first muscle website. And it was here I learned how many figures there were in total, their origins from Japan, and how to recollect them myself. Through the site, I found a young guy named Patrick Gresham who had come across an old warehouse find of cases of unopened muscle four packs, unpunched, meaning the punch hole hadn't been knocked out to hang on store pegs yet. And I bought 100 of these packs from him and ripped them all open. This allowed me to get 121 different figures and 279 duplicates. That's when I turned to eBay, a new online auction site that I had been using since it launched a year earlier. Not only did I sell off all my duplicates, but I was able to get all four pristine, unopened 28 packs and the wrestling ring. And I tore all those open too, because that was the only way to get the remaining 114 figures I needed to complete my 235 flesh-colored or pink muscle set. I was the third person in our online community to complete a set, but I wasn't done. The MPS showed me that muscle was originally from Japan, where it was called Kinnikuman, which translates to Muscle Man, starting as a manga or Japanese comic series by Shonen Jump in 1979 by a creative team named Yuta Tamago, which consisted of writer Takashi Shimada and artist Yoshinori Nakai, and chronicled the adventures of Suguru Kinniku, which we know as Muscle Man, prince of the planet Kinniku, along with his friends and enemies in what began as a parody of popular Chojin, or superhero characters, but evolved into an intergalactic professional wrestling saga with a comedic edge. In 1982, popular character Ramenman got a spin-off manga. And check out that symbol on his shirt. Does it resemble the emblem on another superhero shirt that was on TV in America at that time? Whereas the symbol on the Greatest American Hero's chest was said to be designed after a pair of upside-down scissors, the one on Ramenman's chest is actually the Chinese symbol for the word center or middle. Then in 1983, Kinnikuman was given an anime or Japanese animated series consisting of 137 episodes and 7 movies, as well as a line of keshi or eraser figures that were sold in gashapon, which are vending machine capsules. Then in 1985, Toymakers Mattel, creators of He-Man and the Masters of the Universe, remolded the figures slightly larger and in a harder plastic to unleash on America as Muscle. It was through a guy named Billy Galaxy and some sources in Japan that I was able to obtain many of the Kinnikuman figures that hadn't been turned into Muscle. And I also got a complete run of the manga, as well as a huge collection of the anime on copied VHS tapes, including the entire 46-episode run of a second series that had come out in 1991, as well as some episodes of a spin-off Ramenman anime from 1988. During this collecting frenzy, a new website was launched called the MCW, or Muscle Championship Wrestling. This was a website created by Jason Radniecki, or J-Rad, and it was the most creative website I had ever seen. As a kid, he had painted and named all of his figures and created these elaborate wrestling storylines and filmed some home movies of them with his childhood friend Tim Koch. and then had these continuing storylines play out in photo comic style weekly updates on his site, where you would follow Mean Eugene as he would take you through the backstage and in the ring drama of characters like Mr. Intensity and the Dingo Warrior, and groups like the Gallo Foundation and Dragons of Misfortune. And if you were there at the time, you'll never forget the edge of your seat build up to Nasty Naked Lester. It was this sight that got me to pick up pencil and pen after not having drawn anything in over a year and start making illustrations based on his characters. Then I took the text illustrations of his long-lost Muscle Home movies and started to illustrate them. I started with Junior vs. Godzilla. My original art is on the left, which, after seeing it, he actually paid me to color. Next are its two printings in a fanzine I'll talk about in a minute. You can see how it says MWA Productions. Well, that's because in the 80s, when he made these home movies, the MCW was called MWA, or Muscle Wrestling Alliance. The page was printed twice, because the first one includes the original dialogue from the videotape, which was just grunting sounds, and the second one is in the spirit of the just-released-to-theaters Star Wars Special Edition, where he added in all new dialogue. Now, the second home movie I tackled was Predator 2. Seen here is the first two pages I showed him, and that's when he let me know that even though he hadn't named the figures in his story about the videotape, he did remember which ones he used, and they weren't the ones I chose. So I drew a page of him and his friend Tim as film directors yelling cut and replacing the entire cast with the correct figures and then replaying all those scenes again with the correct cast. And it was these pages that he reformatted, added dialogue to, and were printed. Then he paid me to complete the story, but those pages never got around to being printed, but you can see them here. That brings us back to the MPS, where on Darren's message board, I would continue to draw and post a lot more art. And that's when Darren launched the Muscle Preservation Society Fan Club, of which I am official charter member number 8, and the Muscle Times fanzine. Here's issue number 1 from late 1997. Issue 2 has a variant mistake cover, as well as some artwork from me. And a special thanks to Kevin Maley. Issue 3 has the first MPS Members Contest, which is a trivia quiz where Darren came up with 5 questions about Muscle, and I came up with 5 questions about Kinnikuman. There's a drawing from me. Another drawing from me. I like that guy. He's pretty cool. Another one of my drawings. And this is where Junior vs. Godzilla got printed. Both versions. More of my artwork. That's part of Mike's wrecking crew. Issue 4 was a short bonus issue with some more of my artwork. And issue 5 featured the rare, newly discovered 236th Muscle figure that was not on the collector's poster of figures. And it talks about the origins of that character right here, brought to the community by Patrick Gresham and Kevin Maley, as well as a full page advertisement of my artwork and me selling VHS copies of all of my Kinnikuman anime on 18 6-hour VHS tapes. And you can see here, this is where Predator 2 got printed. And here is the first photo of that rare 236th muscle figure still sealed in an unpunched 4-pack, verifying that this was a true muscle figure and not just a Kanikuman that had made it overseas. And another Kevin drawing. Neat little guy! Issue 6 kicks off 1999 and features more of my artwork. In fact, this little drawing was on an envelope that I sent to Darren. I drew it on the outside of the envelope next to his address. So I guess he scanned that in. But it also includes an article. Oh, another one of my cool drawings. Features an article by a man named Matthew Milner about how to dye your muscle figures into permanent different colors. He's got lots of colors to pick from. Now, he's significant because he hired me to draw character designs and storyboards for an animated series called Galaxy Wrestling that he was promoting to Warner Brothers. And he sent me this package of storyboards from the X-Men animated series on Saturday morning, 1992. And this is the first episode of Season 3, Night of the Sentinels. And this was to teach me how to create storyboards for the industry. This was the same time that I had my first online gallery showcasing my art. And with much of it consisting of this newly created artwork based on wrestling figures, I was hired by a company called Pin and Ink to illustrate a female wrestling comic story. But I was also promoting my superhero comic art, which landed me a job at Quantum Comics on a series called Project Valor. Issue 7 of the Muscle Times is the All Kanikuman issue. And it has a special thanks to me for providing some of the photos of the Kanikuman merchandise from Japan. Issue 8 features more of my artwork, and it talks about how Kanikuman is being relaunched in Japan as a new series based on the grown-up children of the original characters. I also want to mention that during these years, I was actually watching wrestling on TV for the first time. Now, I didn't follow it in its 80s heyday, though, you know, I was aware of who Hulk Hogan and Andre the Giant and Macho Man Randy Savage, and I mean, I'd seen them all, I just didn't follow it. But now I was. Because in the late 90s, it was a real resurgence with a thing called the Monday Night Wars. Two rival wrestling factions on two different networks at the same time every Monday night, with new breakout stars like The Rock and Stone Cold Steve Austin, Kevin Nash, Goldberg, Mick Foley, and more. At the time, it seemed like everyone was watching wrestling. I was delivering for Domino's Pizza back then, and I would go to people's apartments where they would have life-size cardboard standees of The Rock in their living room. Here it is 20 years later, and he's the biggest star in Hollywood. Man, people like that guy. Issue 9 was the last one, and it took all the way to the end of the year 2000 to come out. Changes in my personal life at the time had caused me to back off from the online community and collecting, and it just features some of my straggling illustrations that were left in a pile that I had submitted long before. Being a part of that exclusive club and creating our fanzine is something I've always wanted to be a part of again. I tried to recreate something like it with my Patreon, creating exclusive art and stories and videos for its members, but I could only keep it going for 7 months before I just had to admit to myself that it was never growing beyond its 3 inaugural members. I guess nobody else had an extra dollar to spare, but that's okay because those 3 members made it a lot of fun for me, and I'm still holding out hope that one day I can try something again. In 2001, I got the urge to check back up online to see the things happening with all of my favorite childhood properties, and I came across a web forum called the AKIA, or American Kanikuman Information Archive, created the year before, stemming out of a Yahoo mailing group. It was now the central hub for all things muscle, and consisted of about 99% members that weren't around or even aware of the MPS and the MCW. I joined the forum to learn and connect and talk about the community we had going a few years before. This is the year that muscle figures termed super rare first started to show up, starting with two figures that year and eventually growing to 21 over the next 5 years. These were muscles that had never before been seen in America, but were from the original Kinnikuman line. But these were showing up in America in the muscle plastic. Usually only one example a piece, but a few of them have multiple examples. And oddly enough, the stories of where a lot of these were originally being found in the 80s were around the Buffalo, New York area, where I had to go to find my claw figure. Now, I had referred to this as the hand figure, but it turns out in Kinnikuman, this is actually the clawed foot of a Tyrannosaurus. And I even painted my muscle version. And then I got a larger version. I was collecting a lot of these larger versions of the figures from a Japanese contact named Taka Kurosaka. Now, after posting my old MPS and MCW art to the new IKEA web forums, I started to create and post brand new art. After doing so, IKEA member Raccoon Kaboom suggested a battle art challenge where the artist members of the board would post illustrations of Kinnikuman characters versus non-Kinnikuman characters. And these are some of the ones I came up with. And I think there must have been a contest in there because I won this custom-made articulated figure. At this point, the site expanded and changed its name to LittleRubberGuys.com, where member Universal Ruler Supreme suggested a weekly fan art challenge, and these were many of my entries. Then in 2002, Muscle returned to America as an English dub of the anime based on the grown-up children of the original Kinnikuman characters in a Fox Saturday morning cartoon called Ultimate Muscle. And in 2007, Darren relaunched the MPS. I created this artwork for the relaunch, and here's how it appeared on his new site. Then he started work on a new site called the Muscle Guild, and here's the art that I made for that. Hot on its heels, Jason returned to relaunch the MCW, and I made this art of his main character, Brentano Gallo, rising from the ashes to mark the announcement. And when the site was relaunched, I christened it with a remake of my original Gallo Foundation artwork, which was the first muscle drawing I had ever made. 2008 was the 29th anniversary of Kinnikuman, and this is significant because, if I remember correctly, Kin-Niku, as two separate words, somehow translates into Friday the 29th. So on a Friday of that year, a gigantic box was released with reissues of all 418 of the original flesh-colored figures, and a slew of DVDs containing every episode and movie of the entire animated series. I'm leaving that line in. Now, if I remember correctly, this was, I think, well over $1,000, had to be imported from Japan, and none of the anime had English dubbing or subtitles, so... You know, it's too bad, because it's a really cool cartoon, especially that 46-episode run from 1991, so I didn't buy it. But, you know, at the time, I was kind of getting disillusioned about the whole community and collecting and all of it. The return of Darren and Jason was short-lived, and I left soon as well. The camaraderie of the old days was gone, only to be replaced by a lot of infighting and cutthroat financial trickery based on a hyper-focus of the collecting side. It had just become too much of a business and a lot less of a friendly, fun hobby. So I sold all of my original collection of muscle figures and all of my manga, and I took all my VHS tapes and threw them in the trash. That was it. But 5 years later, in 2013, during the heyday of filling my vault, I bought that set of 418 figures, sans DVDs, and I created this stadium-style seating display case for them. Unfortunately, like everything in my vault, it has just sat there collecting dust for the last 5 years. And after I'm done filming this, they're all going up on eBay as well. But for those of you still interested in collecting, Muscle has made a return. In 2015, a company called Super 7 obtained the license to the name Muscle, but not the original Kinnikuman characters. So they are releasing all new properties under the Muscle headline in retro 80s style Muscle packaging. Figures like Masters of the Universe and Alien, which I've showcased in several of my earlier videos, and properties like Street Fighter. And in Japan, Kinnikuman continues to this day as a manga in new issues of Shonen Jump, and occasional appearances in new PlayStation games. Until next time. It's like I said, you gotta buy one if you wanna get one free. Stupid, stupid. Yes. You know how hard it is to remember all this stuff?